Hi, I'm Vance, and welcome back to Repair and Replace. In this episode, I'll show you how to replace the solenoid in an American Standard Selectronic Flushometer. To begin, you'll need a solenoid, a 2.5 millimeter hex wrench, a flat blade screwdriver, a Phillips screwdriver, and a smooth jaw wrench. Flushometers, or flush valves, are just automatically timed self-closing valves. At rest, water is at equal pressure in the upper and lower chambers. This keeps the piston closed tightly on the valve seat. When the sensor is triggered, the solenoid activates and releases water from the upper chamber, which decreases the pressure. High-pressure water from the inlet now lifts the piston up and travels down the flush pipe. During the flush, some of the water is forced back into the upper chamber through a small bypass hole in the piston. The flush continues until the pressure equalizes and pushes the piston down onto the valve seat. Now, if the solenoid is stuck open, it can cause continuous flushing as water continues to flow out and prevents the upper chamber from filling with water. If the solenoid fails to open, it can prevent the unit from functioning at all. First, shut off the water to the flushometer. Remove the cap and use a flat blade screwdriver to turn the screw clockwise until the control stop closes. Next, hold down the button to remove any remaining water. Use a 2.5 millimeter hex wrench to loosen the set screw on the back of the cover. Now lift up the cover and unplug the solenoid. Use the smooth jaw wrench to remove the bonnet nut. Gently rock the solenoid back and forth and lift up to remove. Now, if you're replacing the whole subassembly, you can just skip the next step. First, remove the locking screw. Rotate the solenoid a quarter turn counterclockwise and separate it from the piston. Next, discard the old solenoid. Push the new solenoid into the piston. Rotate it a quarter turn clockwise to lock it into place. Now, tighten the locking screw. Push the subassembly down into the flushometer. Feed the wire through the bonnet nut and tighten the nut to secure the assembly. Now attach the sensor wire. Replace the cover and tighten the set screw. Turn on the water by opening the control stop. Now test the flushometer and adjust the control stop until you get a normal flush with a quiet operation. Finally, replace the cap. If you found this video useful, then subscribe to our channel. We're constantly filming new content every week, so let us know what repairs you'd like to see next. Now, if you need a part for that repair, then explore our website. We stock thousands of hard-to-find parts, and we'll ship it out to you the same day. Thanks for watching.